As XXX Tentacion was leaving the motorcycle dealership, a vehicle of men pulled up, blocked him in, jumped out, started shooting at him, ended up taking his life. Today, we're actually looking at this footage. It's been released, along with footage of X inside of the dealership when the criminals were plotting on him. Let's see what we've got here today. So first off, notice how X is standing here talking to the guy working the dealership, looking at the motorcycles. Notice right here, check out that look where he looks back again. He looks at them once, he kind of looks away. Now keep this in mind here, because I really want you to see this. Look at the glance, that's a strong glance right there, he's looking at them. Now, if you're familiar with X, you'll know he was a really spiritual person. And I believe he had a strong power of intuition, and that he knew something wasn't right. He could feel it. He sensed the danger, and that's why immediately you'll see he kind of turns off. He's all right, we gotta get out of here now. Also, just look at the way he's looking over at them, while his friend over here is just kind of moseying along, not really too aware of what's going on. Now these are the scumbags responsible for X's death. You have Dedrick Williams, aka Tattoo Man Chucky, who was one of the ones we saw walking by, along with Robert Allen. The two of them walked by while they were inside. Now Michael Boatwright and Trayvon Newsom, on the other hand, were the two gunmen who hopped out of the vehicle. Now, the suspects are all pleading not guilty. One of them, Dedrick Williams, even having the audacity to seek $10,000 for his own private investigation to prove his innocence. Now, some people are really upset with X's friend who was with him when this happened, because you'll see here, his friend jumps out of the car, he's being shot at as well, and he runs away. Now, my question is, what would you have done if you were in this situation? He didn't have any weapons with him. But he did abandon X. He didn't try to stop. Even if he had tried to stop them, you can't fight two people with guns when you don't have guns. So, I'd love to know from you, what do you think? Do you think that was wrong of him to run away like that? Most of us have never been in that situation. Hopefully none of us ever will be. And another question I have for you is, once someone reaches the certain level of fame, should they have security with them everywhere they go? A lot of people don't want to be seen as soft, and they may think, oh, it's soft when you have security, but no. There comes a point where you just have to be smart about things. And once you have that level of where you're known, you have to have some sort of security with you wherever you go. They can't 100% stop this sort of thing from happening, but they can definitely deter some of these would-be thugs who would try to kill you and take what you have. For future updates on this story, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. I've got a playlist where we've been learning so much of this pinned in the pinned comment below. Until next time, everybody, be safe and God bless.
Baby, I don't understand it. You're changing, I can't stand it. My heart can't take this damage. And the way I feel, can't stand it. Baby, I don't understand it. You're changing, I can't stand it. My heart can't take this damage. And the way I feel, can't stand it. Baby, I don't understand it. I can't stand it.